September 11th was a sunny day in New York City. Longtime Savannah resident Randall Robinson had just arrived for a U.S. Customs Service seminar on the fourth floor of number 6 World Trade Center, one of the buildings that would soon be gone.
And then all of a sudden there was a boom, then a rumble, rumble, bump, bump. One of the New Yorkers who was leading the seminar said, "Oh, we don't have earthquakes around New York very often." We were thinking, Then there was a scraping sound. You hear the scraping noise, and oh, somebody's moving furniture. Well, we were thinking, I don't know about that. Several of us were saying, I don't know. Then somebody stuck their head in the door and said, okay, everybody out now.
Randall Robinson remembers it all like it was yesterday, how they all dashed down the stairs to the street below. He looked up and saw the smoke. Somebody said a corporate jet must have struck the building. He could not figure out how the pilot could have done it.
Gosh, must have been a heart attack or a stroke, because you couldn't miss seeing the tower. It was beautiful weather. And so I sure hope they'll get them out of there. So I pulled out my camera and took pictures of the burning building.
He snapped about 10 photos before realizing just what he was witnessing.
And I gave out a film, didn't have but 8 shots left on that roll, and I put another roll in, and then somebody said, oh my gosh, people are jumping. I said, no more pictures. I'm not getting pictures of that.
He thought the firefighters would put it out, but they had no chance.
Somebody said, oh my God, here comes another one. Another one? And then looked up and saw this plane coming down the Hudson River, and it banked hard left and went over my head, and the engine was screaming, and it hit, you know, World Trade Center number 2.
He finally made it back to his hotel room, and on TV with the other guests watched as the first tower fell and then the other, taking with it the building he had evacuated.
Do some more walking around and walk past the site, and where the custom house had been in the middle of all that was an iron cross. I thought that was kind of ironic, you know, just the Lord looking out for us.